Hare Krishna. A rigid structure may not work for us, but without a structure, we may not work. We all have a dynamic tension with the structures in our life. The structures may be the rules, they may be the schedules, they may be the etiquettes, and sometimes we may feel that these restrict and constrict us too much. So I have to do this at that this time, and I have to do that at that time. So sometimes we may feel I'm more spontaneous. I want to do what I want to do when I want to do it. So we may say structures don't work for me. It's possible some people like to work according to proper plans. Some people want to be more spontaneous. That's fine. But we needn't reject all structure just because some structure doesn't work for us. Why is that? Because if our mind is remarkably restless and there is a thin line between being spontaneous and being uncommitted, being random, being irresponsible. So spontaneous means, oh, this comes up, let me do this. But uncommitted means just going here, there and everywhere. So the mind is chanchal, restless, Krishna says in the Bhagavad-Gita. And therefore, if we have no structure at all, then we will not be able to function at all. We need even people who are engaged in creative fields such as writing. Writers may write beautifully and profusely when they are inspired, but other times also they keep writing something or the other because they know that that structure will keep them moving. And we all need to see what structure works best for us for managing ourselves, our mind. And thus the Bhagavad-Gita says that when it comes to managing the mind, we need the appropriate method. Asanyatatmana yogo dushprapiti me mati vashyatmana tu yatata shakyo vaptum upayataha. If we don't regulate our minds and discipline ourselves, then any perfection, including the spiritual perfection of yoga, is impossible. But if we adopt the appropriate process, then it is possible to manage the mind and move towards making building a future, a life for ourselves that is fulfilling, that is meaningful. So the practice, the principles and practices of Bhakti Yoga, in fact, the whole process of Bhakti Yoga gives us a structure that also gives room for spontaneity. And when we adopt the principles of Bhakti Yoga and create appropriate structures for ourselves in our life with as much flexibility or rigidity as works best for us, then we can unleash our creativity and our spirituality for our and others' good. Thank you. Hare Krishna.